What is up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. My name is Travis. Of course, this is TWA Motorsports. And yes, we did get a new daily driver. So if you guys caught the last video, this is coattailing right off of that. 2 days ago, I sold the MBS crew cab, the lowered crew cab. And I know it's going to disappoint a lot of people because they really like that truck. But I bought something different and I kind of had in mind what I wanted to buy. And I had looked, found several of them, and we'll kind of talk about that experience because it wasn't a fun one. But either way, we do have a replacement, which I'm going to show you in just a second. But so I had to have a daily driver. There was nothing out here that I really wanted to drive every day, especially since when I filmed that video a couple days ago of the truck leaving, it was 80 degrees. Today it's 30. And so they're calling for possible snow tomorrow. That's just the way it is in Missouri. And I didn't want to drive, like, I probably would have drove the white Trans Am here, even though I'm in the middle of doing some stuff on it. But I don't think it doesn't really do good in the snow. And I really don't want to drive it in the snow if I don't have to. So I wanted something that I knew would be dependable. And let's take a look at what it is. We're going to talk about some of the plans, talk about my experience in trying to find this thing. But it is a MBS Yukon, right? So I know you guys, I've obviously got a soft spot for the MBS model. I just really like the look of them. I like the shape of the SUVs in this era. I don't know what it is. It's just something about them. I really like them. So I was dead set on getting a Yukon. I really wanted a Yukon over a Tahoe because obviously a while back we had an MBS Tahoe. Z71 that I lowered and did some stuff to, and we sold it. But I wanted the front end like the front end on my truck. I just like that front end. I think it looks classier in my opinion than the Silverado or the Tahoe of the same years. And it's really weird that they did the Tahoe, they never changed to that cat-eyed front end. It's weird that they ran that all the way through the change without going to that cat eye front end. I've seen a lot of guys that have swapped to the cat eye front end, and I'm kind of controversial on the cat eye. I mean, I like it, but it's not my favorite. This is my favorite front end. And so I was dead set on a Yukon. I really wanted a Yukon, but this is a 2004 Yukon SLT two wheel drive. I didn't need a four wheel drive really. These things get around pretty good in the snow, even the two wheel drive models. And we still have the newer Yukon that is four wheel drive, but either way, let's talk about the experience of buying this real quick, and then we'll get into a little more on what's going on with it. But ultimately, I had about five of these spotted before the truck. I knew the truck was sold. I've had a deposit on it for a while, but I've had like five of these spotted. Well, two of those sold in that time, but there were three left. And so one of them was in Kansas, one in like the Tulsa area, and one in Texas, and I think they were both, one in Kansas and two in Oklahoma. So either way, I decided after the guy left, the same day the guy left with the truck, I was going to look at a set of wheels for another project, which is actually the Trans Am, and it didn't pan out. But I thought, well, we'll look at these Yukons if we're close and see if something works out, because I really wanted something by the time I go to work next week to drive. So one of the Yukons that was in Kansas, the person would only respond to Facebook Messenger posts if it would take them like 6 hours. This had been going on for a week, so before I even sold the truck. And I told him, I said, hey, I want to come up there. It's like 3.5 hours away. Can you just give me a phone number so I have another contact? Since they were kind of slow to respond, I thought, that's just how it is with Messenger. Sometimes people just don't respond really quickly. So I wanted a phone number. They wouldn't give me one. They said that they'd been scammed before by giving out their phone number, so they wouldn't give me a phone number. So I'm not gonna drive 3.5 hours for somebody that responds every 12 hours on a Messenger thread. I'm not gonna set up there for 12 hours while they respond, wondering where it's at. So it just gave me a weird feeling that they just didn't, I don't know. I just didn't wanna do that. And maybe they have been scammed, but either way, that one didn't work out. So I had found another one. That one was a 2004 as well, same color. I really wanted white, silver, gold, something in that. I wanted a lighter color. I didn't want a dark color like black or blue or any of those. I would have loved to have had a red one, but the red one is the older generation. And I will tell you guys that the the O3 up, they changed all the switches on the inside, and they're just a little better made. And then they, of course, had the doubled in radio. So those are two of the, I really wanted an O3 up because of that. But to find a red one, they stopped making red in 2002, so you would have had to went with the old school stuff. But either way, I couldn't find a red one. And guys, these things are stupid, stupid money right now. People are selling absolute trash for $3,500. Interiors are thrash. They don't run. They're dented up. They're rusty. Anywhere from $35,000 to $4,000. And I just don't think that they're worth that kind of money in that condition. Now, 2 years ago, you could have bought these things for dirt cheap and in decent condition. But for some reason right now, unless you catch somebody that's got a bad transmission or just wants out of it, they're really tough to find. So either way, I decided there were two that I was gonna go look at, one of which was a 2001. It was pewter. Pictures looked awesome. It had 140,000 miles on it, I think. So decent mileage as far as for the year. And I thought, that's it, that's the one. And we'll go look at that one. And then like an hour away from it, there was another one that was like a 90,000 mile one. And I thought, well, one of those two will definitely work. So I put all my eggs in that basket, drove down, looked at the pewter one. The pewter one, guys, I got out, walked around it for 10 seconds, got back in my vehicle and left. It was that rough. Pictures, while it's tough to judge something by pictures, especially with this amount of age on it, I get out, they had obviously been painted on it. Well, they had painted on it before. Pewter's a really tough color to match. They did a good job on the match. The problem is they painted around the trim and then they took the trim off. So you could see the line, and there was a couple rust spots on it. That wasn't it. Like, it took me less than 10 seconds. I didn't even need to start it or anything. It didn't matter because I'd rather have one that didn't run than one that was rusty and had paint issues. I do not want to mess with paint issues. I got enough going on. I don't need one gone in a body shop for 2 months. So like, okay, we'll just go look at the low mileage one, right? There was a 2004 Yukon. That's what I wanted anyway, the 03 up. It's got low mileage. They were asking stupid money for it. They were asking $8,500. Now look, it looked super clean in the pictures. I did a VIN search on it. I noticed it had been wrecked before, but it was a pretty simple fix. Like, it had creases down the door, like where it ran up against something. Not something that would be tough to fix, honestly. But it was already fixed. I just noticed that in the past that had happened. So I thought, well, I'm just gonna have to pony up, pay $8,500. They would not budge on price over the phone. I thought, well, maybe if I get there and I like it, maybe 8,000 will buy it or something. I get there, jump out of the car, same situation. Took me about 10 seconds to realize that's not the one either. The door alignment was terrible. They'd obviously put a door on it. They didn't even fix, whatever hit it ran all the way down the side. They didn't fix the very back. It just looked terrible. And I wasn't like, look, I might have sprung for that one in the $5,000 range and fixed those issues, but for $8,500 and them not budging, I knew that I had no chance. I didn't even make an offer on it. It was just too much. Now, the interior was really clean, obviously, with that low of mileage, but yeah. So now I'm stuck. Like, I'm a couple hours away from home, and I really don't want to drive back. So I get on Facebook Marketplace in a gas station parking lot, me, my wife, and my youngest son, and I'm scavenging trying to find something, and this popped up like 12 hours before. Now, this one did say that it had a clean body, clean title, but there was some issues with the computer. It was a computer issue, they said. And so luckily the guy messaged me back within like 5 minutes, and it was his parents. He was listing it for his parents. And what's funny is, guys, he actually watches the channel. He's got an MBS truck as well, which is awesome. But he didn't know that to begin with, but he responded to me, said, yeah, there's some computer issues. It does this weird thing where it goes into reduced power mode. Pretty common problem with these. But I said, well, is the body good? And he said, yeah, the body's in great shape. So it was only like 10 minutes away from where I had stopped. So I drove over there. It's almost dark, which I hate to look at vehicles, you know, in the dark. I got enough daylight to see that the body is in incredible shape, guys. It's absolutely amazing. There's a few door dings here and there, which is to be, you know, look, that's gonna happen on a vehicle this age, but no rust. They've obviously washed it, kept it somewhat clean. Now, not to my level, I'm at a different level as far as cleanliness goes, but it's been cared for. You can tell that they've actually cared for it. And so they were explaining to me that they had replaced several things on it, and they were just tired of replacing it. They're just going to sell it. They're tired of messing with it. And they said sometimes in the mornings, you go to start it, it goes in that reduced power mode and it won't go over like 40 miles an hour, which if you guys have experienced that, pretty common issue on these. While I've not had a ton, my Suburban had that issue, I've not had a ton of them do that, but I know it's an issue on these. So I started up, it actually ran fine then, drove it down the road, and ultimately ended up buying it. But they had replaced the throttle pedal, the throttle position sensor, they replaced the throttle body, they put an oil pump in it because they thought the oil pressure was a little low at one point. And so it's had a few things done to it, but it ran perfect on the way home until this morning. And this morning when I went to move it, it did go into that reduced power mode, and it's when it's cold, which generally lends me to believe that it's probably a throttle body issue. Now, while they did put a new throttle body on it, I did see the box and it was a Dorman. And guys, if you ever replace a throttle body on these, replace it with a GM unit. So they've been known to be bad out of the box from like Dorman or places like that, some aftermarket companies. So it's always good to replace that. So it could just be as simple as a throttle body. There's also some ground issues on these things that cause them to do that. If you guys look on the internet, I'm not even going to show you. I'm going to run a couple extra grounds, but from this pin on the firewall on both sides, from there, a lot of people ground to like the alternator bracket, or they ground to the control module for the throttle pedal over there, or ground directly to the battery or to the computer. Some people say that fixes it, some don't. Now look, if it's a throttle body issue, none of that stuff is going to fix it. But the fact that it only happens in the morning lends me to believe it's probably more of a throttle body issue than it is a wiring issue, because I don't hit a bump and it happens. It literally starts in the morning like that when it's cool, which lends me, like I said, to believe that it's the throttle body. But either way, you know, pretty clean, not under the hood, but as far as the bodies and stuff like that goes, that's more what I was concerned about. The rest of the stuff we can fix. And so, yes, I do have plans on this. Since it's two-wheel drive, we're obviously going to drop it, guys. We got a lot of cleaning to do in the interior to get it to my level. This is pretty common, the seat to be ripped. I probably will fix that eventually. It's not real high on my priority list. Right now, I just want to drive the thing and do little odds and ends things, show you guys as I go along. I talked about, you know, a lot of these things, these projects in here are bigger projects, and so they take a while to do. And so when I can just do, you know, I can do a couple things here and there on this and make videos for you guys, and I think that a lot of you guys are going to dig what this looks like when it's all finished up. It's a win-win for me. I can still come out here and tinker, and like I told you in the last video, I love to tinker on stuff like this, kind of make it my own, and then start over on another daily driver. So as long as we can drive it daily, no issues, while we're working on all this other stuff, and then tinker with this, that is the ultimate goal. But so 159,000 miles on this thing, you know, there's really not much to say. It just needs a good cleanup on the outside, inside. I plan on debadging. I'm gonna leave the door trim on. I really kind of like that. I am gonna take probably the Yukon badges off, the SLT badges. There's a dealer badge on the back I'm going to take off. Other than that, I do kind of like the billet grill. I actually went back and forth on putting one of those in this. I think they look kind of neat in them. I didn't want to cut my brand new grill in my green truck to put one in. And in order to make them fit properly, you really need to trim that. So I'm going to leave that, I think. Replace the headlights. It already has some LEDs in it, but I want to replace the housings because they're kind of yellowed. And just ultimately clean it up. You guys know how I am on this stuff. It needs a windshield. It's got a crack in the windshield. The headliner is beginning to fall on the front leading edge. That'll probably be a while since it's got the rear AC. It's got stuff in the ceiling. I don't know how soon I'll get to that, or even if I will. I probably will eventually. But the wheels are actually 18-inch wheels off of Dodge. I've seen a lot of people doing this lately, putting Dodge wheels on these. And while they don't look terrible, it's not really my style. So I don't love those. Probably gonna get rid of those. Well, I know I'm gonna get rid of those, and I'll talk about that here in just 1 second. But ultimately, guys, I paid $5,200 for this. And while many of you may think that's too much, guys, I'm telling you, if you find one where the body is in this good a shape for $5,200, even if it has a few minor issues, I think it's worth it. So We'll probably pile a bunch of money into it and lose money. That's pretty much what I do, but it's fun for me to tinker on. And but anyway, so while we were out there buying this, I thought, well, as long as we're not close to home, let's see if there's any wheels out there for sale for this, because I had an idea kind of what wheel I wanted, just like I had an idea of what kind of vehicle I wanted. And so I found a couple sets of wheels. I just wanted a stock set of GM 20s, and I found a set like maybe 40 minutes away, and that is what these are over here. Now, while the tires are not going to go on it, they're like mud tires and they're ridiculously heavy. I'm going to put some street tires on it, but this is the wheel that I wanted. These wheels are kind of tough to find in decent shape. It's the wheel that I originally had on the green truck when I bought it. I then moved them to that white Tahoe, the MBS Tahoe, the Z71. And then I also bought these wheels for the red step side. So when I sold the red step side, this is what it had on it. I really wanted to keep them because they were in good shape, but I didn't have another set to sell it with. So these are the wheels that I chose, 2014 and up GMC Sierra wheels. I just think they look really, really nice. And like I said, while I'm not gonna be using the tires, that's ridiculous on a two-wheel drive. The plan is to get new tires and sell these tires. Now, these tires are in great shape. I'm assuming this guy took them off. He had a 2014 GMC. I'm assuming he took them off because they're ridiculously noisy, because the ones he had on it were nowhere near as aggressive. Like these, they're so heavy to take in and out, and I don't know, I just not my style, and obviously on a two-wheel drive it would look weird anyway. Now I could go ahead and put them on, but I don't even think I'm gonna mess with it. I think I'm gonna wait until I get new tires on, and I'm hoping that selling these tires, selling the wheels and tires, will offset the cost of this whole deal. So I may be in this free and clear. I paid $800 for wheels and tires. I talked to my tire guy. He said, while these are a pretty cheap brand of tire, he said they're still probably worth $300 to $500. I'd have to agree with him. They're pretty aggressive tread. I think somebody out there would probably want this on their vehicle. And then same thing with the old wheels. I think they're worth a couple $100. So if I can get $300 to $500 out of these, and then let's say $300 to $500 out of the wheels that are on the Yukon, then I'm almost at a break even for no money, right? That makes it worth it, in my opinion. But either way, I wanted to show you guys the newest addition to the garage, the new daily driver, the thing that you're going to be seeing videos on. I'm gonna start just a new series on it as well. And then of course continuing all the other stuff that we're working on. I'm hoping to have, I keep getting pushed off on my transmission. I'm hoping to have it next week for the green truck. I'm hoping to get you guys a video on the Trans Am soon to talk about what I'm doing with it. Other than that, then once those things are accomplished, I'm hoping to maybe get some work done on the green 55. I'm hoping to get some stuff done on the red Trans Am. But either way, guys, hopefully you enjoyed this video. Hopefully you like the new vehicle for the channel. I think a lot of you guys will. It seems like you guys are big truck fans, and to me, this is a truck. It's just a bigger version of it. But if you did enjoy the video, like always, guys, please smash that thumbs up button. If you are not subscribed, please go down there, hit that subscribe. Of course, ring the bell icon. That notifies you every time we drop a new video. And stay tuned to see what we work on next.